I'll move to slide number one, which talks about a few things. Now, if coaching is to be blamed, or coaching is the current state of affairs, which is extremely important, we'll spend maybe out of those 20 minutes, 10 minutes in coaching, 5 minutes in hiring, because we had a very strong representation from the hiring side, from Aparna. I love the presentation. And then training, yes, I'd like to share the basics. Now, hiring. Now, when we talk about hiring, the famous saying says, we hire for attitude, right? And train for skills. Now, if we have to hire for attitude, if I rightly believe, within this room, there are almost 80-85 sales recruiters. All of you have your set pattern or skill levels when it comes to interviewing people, right, sir? Yeah? So you can actually scan a candidate by your own experience that, okay, this candidate is supposed to be good or average, and you have got enough connect with the industry, or even if you flick through this character's, with due respect, LinkedIn profile, you get to know about the candidate a lot. Now that's smart. But if we see the current heading, which talks about sales predictability and performance for 2012. Now, in this quarter at least, we need to recruit absolutely right. Not trying to preach you, but again, basis a number of case studies and discussions and observations, as an outsider, I'd love to share a couple of my insights, which talks about recruiting the right team. Now, right team will be predictable. Now, if it's predictable, if you want to make a prediction, what do we see first? Let's say in the financial markets, if we have the guts to make a prediction, what do? We see the past records. You're right. So recruiting right team starts from identifying the right placement agency who will genuinely help to screen candidates, help create job descriptions, matching candidates data bank which they have. Now, this screen candidates means, I mean, many a times we give or get a candidate which is tentatively or somewhat close to that profile if you see the JD. But they have the right to screen, they should ideally. So we'll have to identify those placement agencies and verify backgrounds of previous performance at a pre-recruitment stage. Now, many a times we run an Authbridge reference check or FAQ reference check after the recruitment. Now that it is done. Now, recruiting and reversing the decision is very, very painful for any possible cost center. Yeah? So, senior leaderships many a times hire because of a huge halo effect in the candidate. Please tell me, what is the typo or the spelling error in this particular slide?
Nothing.
What's it?
No typo.
What is the typo error in this particular slide? There's one mistake. A spelling mistake. Wonderful, it's halo effect. And what is halo effect, by the way? All of us, we know that it's a cognitive bias. Like what happens, suddenly some company is doing exceedingly well, share prices have gone up, the company is sustaining goods, I'm talking about the set of customers. Now, CEO is a visionary, team is exemplary, but the moment business stands, what happens? We just reverse all our opinions. Now, this halo effect talks about, okay, if I'm an ex-banker, I'd love to see a person who's very much dressed like a banker, knows a lot of people in our old boys network, discusses the same in the interview, and we're comfortable with that. So this guy has a fair chance, to my opinion, that okay, this guy can be a very good fitment to that role. Now, many a times, the recruitment influence that comes top down to the recruiting manager to take a biased decision. This point was touched in one of our presentations earlier. Now, what happens typically, if a regional head is to be recruited, now he needs to be screened by the sales head, then a cross-matching opinion from the HR, and finally the CEO interview. Now just imagine if CEO knows this guy beforehand, if he calls him to the forum as a first level interview, then it trickles down to the next layers. It's a little difficult for the other people to take decisions. There are a lot of gutsier people who can take a very right decision, but many a times these opinions get biased. Agree? So, let's say since the top management has approved the candidate, it becomes extremely difficult to share a different opinion from many of the decision influencers. right? So is there the best method to recruit? Now, point blank, if you want to share with all of us something which is very close to our heart, we should ideally follow a dedicated interview matrix, which includes a questionnaire, which includes situation handling. Many of us, we have that. But at times, we go by our gut feeling and we just neglect that. Follow effect, so, okay? So situation handling, leadership questions, customer service excellence, because in today's environment, any of our clients, if he shoots a email, he or she, no gender bias here, shoots an email to the CEO, what happens? Suddenly, all of us, we try to track this client and try to offer a customer delight, at times which is not so logical. That happens, just one email, that shakes the whole system, yeah? So, it's better to have a clear metrics which talks about situation handling, leadership questions,